Hello little scientist, welcome to ALLEN IntelliBrain. In this video, we will visualize and identify the types of polygons and their interior angles by performing the Intelli activity on identifying the types of polygons and deriving the formula for calculating the sum of all the interior angles of a polygon. From your Intelli SMART Box, take out the Polygons card sheet, geometry kit and the marker pen. Place the geometry kit, the marker and the polygon cards on a table. Observe the polygon cards. There are two polygon cards of each type having same number of sides and they are marked as A and B. Now let's pick a polygon card and find out that whether it is a regular or an irregular polygon. I have picked the pentagon card A. Take out the ruler and protractor from the geometry kit. I am using this scale and the circular disc. You can use any scale and any protractor from your geometry kit. Keep the ruler and protractor aside. Let's mark the vertices of this pentagon card A as M, N, O, P, Q. Now let's measure each side of this pentagon like this. Side MN is 7 centimeters. Side NO is 5.8 centimeters. Side OP is 6 centimeters. Side PQ is 6 centimeters. Side QM is 5.8 centimeters. Note that all the sides are not equal. Now let's measure each angle using this circular disc. To measure each angle with the protractor, align the base of the protractor with the side. So angle M is 103 degrees. Angle N is 103 degrees. You can measure the rest of the angles in a similar manner. Here angle O is 113 degrees. Angle P is 108 degrees. And angle Q is 113 degrees. Note that each angle is not equal. When one side or an angle of a polygon is different than the rest, then it is an irregular polygon. Therefore, we can say that this pentagon card A is not a regular polygon. Now let's pick pentagon card B. Repeat the same steps to measure each side of this pentagon card. We have marked each vertex as M, N, O, P and Q. On measuring each side, we have found that each side is 6 centimeters. Here, all the sides are equal. Let's now measure each angle using the circular disc in the same manner as before. Here, angle M is 108 degrees. After measuring each angle, we have found that every angle is 108 degrees. Here, all the angles are also equal. Note that if all the sides and all the angles are equal, then we say that it is a regular polygon. Therefore, pentagon card B is a regular polygon. Let's now perform an interesting activity, that is deriving the formula for calculating the sum of the interior angles of a polygon. Place the pentagon card, the ruler and the marker on a table. Observe that the angle enclosed by the adjacent sides, these are the interior angles of this polygon. We have marked each vertex as M, N, O, P and Q. Note that we have labeled each vertex inside this polygon. We usually label each vertex outside the figure. Now we will draw diagonals to connect the opposite vertices with vertex M. Here, these are adjacent vertices and these are opposite vertices. Let's join the vertex M with vertex P and O. Observe that there are three non-overlapping triangles are formed, named as M, N, O, M, O, P and M, P, Q. We know that sum of all the angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Here we have three triangles. Therefore, the sum of the interior angles of three triangles is equal to 3 multiplied by 180 degrees, and that is equal to 540 degrees. Hence, the sum of the interior angles of a pentagon is equal to 540 degrees. Now let's take another polygon, that is hexagon. Let's find out its sum of interior angles by following the same steps. Mark the vertices using the marker as A, B, C, D, E and F. As we can see that from vertex A, vertex B and vertex F are adjacent. So we will draw diagonals to connect vertex A with vertex C, vertex A with vertex D and vertex A with vertex E. The triangles formed are ABC, ACD, ADE and AEF. There are four triangles. Therefore, the sum of all the interior angles of four triangles is 4 multiplied by 180 degrees. That is equal to 720 degrees. Hence, the sum of the interior angles of a hexagon is 720 degrees. Let's observe these calculations. In pentagon, the number of sides are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. The number of non-overlapping triangles are 1, 2, 3. Or can we say that 5 minus 2. Therefore, the sum of all the interior angles of a pentagon is equal to 3 multiplied by 180 degrees or 5 minus 2 whole bracket multiplied by 180 degrees. In hexagon, the number of sides are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The number of non-overlapping triangles are 1, 2, 3, 4 or 6 minus 2. Therefore, the sum of all the interior angles of a hexagon is equal to 4 multiplied by 180 degrees or 6 minus 2 whole bracket multiplied by 180 degrees. If I say that number of sides are n in a polygon, then number of non-overlapping triangles will be n minus 2. Therefore, the sum of the interior angles of a n-sided polygon will be n minus 2 multiplied by 180 degrees. Therefore, the formula for calculating the sum of the interior angles of a n-sided polygon will be n minus 2 multiplied by 180 degrees. Let's apply this formula for hexagon. Number of sides in a hexagon are 6. So, n is equal to 6. The formula for calculating the sum of the interior angles of a n-sided polygon is n minus 2 multiplied by 180 degrees. That is 6 minus 2 multiplied by 180 degrees, which is equal to 4 multiplied by 180 degrees, and that is equal to 720 degrees. Look, it is same as we have obtained before. Now you can show this to your friends and help them in finding the sum of the interior angles of a polygon. After doing this activity, you will have gained the expertise in the following concepts: visualizing and classifying the types of polygons on the basis of their properties, understanding and deriving the formula for calculating the sum of all the interior angles of a polygon, visualize maths with ALLEN IntelliBrain and fall in love with learning.